The theme behind it is like everybody's talking about this soft girl era, but like nobody's domesticated anymore, everybody's pretty wrong. So it's like teaching skills, like I guess you know, domesticated women in a sense.
These two right here?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's the top, it's the bottom. New York Fashion Week was amazing. I was there for about 6 or 7 days. This was my second year going as talent, third year styling, so it was amazing. I attended the Theater Magazine show, attended Barbara Hunt show, was there with my publicist and a couple of other people, Desi Orr. We took it by storm. I mean, it was amazing. The crowd was lit, the people was lit, the shows was lit, so yeah. For sure, we have some Haute Couture looks, avant-garde, custom looks. We have JL, the designer. We have Frankie, my girl, she came through with the pieces. Gotta Be Jelly on these pieces. We have a little bit of From Grayscale. We have a couple of custom coats that we're gonna get into. This is from Verdict Still Out. Definitely gonna be a moment. By Jayella. Fire. And then yeah, I can't give y'all too much. You know, you guys gonna have to just stay tuned for that, but yeah.
Some of the dopest people I've gotten to work with. One of the dopest brands I've gotten to work with was the Nike brand. I've done a couple projects with them. We did the Fam 5 project. We went down to Tallahassee, Florida to FAMU, and LeBron James partnered with FAMU to release a sneaker and put his logo on the sneaker and jerseys. So that was one of the dopest projects I worked on. Doing some stuff with Cardi B, that was super dope. We was out there in LA with Cardi B for like 2.5, maybe 3 weeks, working on one of her big videos, which was the Up video. We documented that whole journey. I had directed the video, and I had the opportunity to photograph her out there. That was dope. And then on the release date of the Up video, I flew back to LA to photograph Cardi B, so that was super dope as well, just to be right there sitting with her. As the video premiered, I was right there next to her, you know, just being able to share that moment with her, that was super dope. I've also did some stuff with Lotto multiple times. She's the homie, Flo Milli, Big Boy from Outkast, super legend, Westside Gunn, and the list goes on.
And how do you plan on bringing this shoot to life today?
Well, today, you know, I'm gonna put my icing on it. I know the stylist got some fire pieces, and I know Tia, she's gonna come prepared. So, you know, I'm gonna do what I do best and kill this shit. That's how I'm gonna do it.
Thank you, brother.
Thank you.
What are things?
The silver earrings, the dangling ones.
Like, they be running from me, like.
Literally. Not for me, that drop.
For real.
Kind of like, you know, like, lean in your pose a little bit. Kind of towards me.
What's up, y'all? It's your boy, The Real Experience, celebrity wardrobe stylist, and I have here with me my girl, Taya Cooper.
Yes, welcome.
Go ahead, how you doing?
How you feeling? How's the shoot going?
I'm feeling good. I love the energy in here. It's an all-black crew, so that was super dope.
Fire.
And then you really did your big one with the look, so I'm excited for everybody to see them. They look good.
Likewise. I mean, I think it's going good. I think that, like, with all the looks, like you said, just the energy, the personality, the vibes, I think we got it.
Great
group.
Yeah.
So, speaking as far as, like, style and fashion, what do you think of brands that you like to wear, how you vibe, or just, like, in general?
I like Diesel. I like Prada.
Okay.
I love Balenciaga, but they in some stuff right now. So.
Facts.
And I really like the simple one. I like Gavin's Department. I like Da Vinci.
Rick Owens.
I love Rick Owens.
I can tell.
yeah, I love that little edgy streetwear, but still like,
luxury. And that's crazy that you say that, because, like, not to cut you off, but, like, my whole aura, my whole aesthetic is, like, integrating luxury and streetwear, because I feel like a lot of the times people, you know, you either have to pick one, but people like Rick Owens and the Gallery Department, they're kind of merging that integration with luxury and streetwear. So, yeah, that's a vibe. You got me with Diesel, you got me with Gallery Department for sure.
I like Chrome Price too.
Hard, that's a vibe. Yeah.
I like Marnie.
Marnie on me. Okay. What about, let's see. Amiri? How you feel about that whole conversation?
Amiri is like, I don't know.
Got you. I feel it.
I feel like I said a lot, but I.
No, you said enough, because that whole situation. Yeah. But, would you, okay, so like on an average day, what would you say, how would you say your style speaks to you? I know, just give you a little backstory. I know for me, like, I normally express myself through fashion. So, like, when I'm down, I'll probably put on, like, a sweatsuit or whatever. When I want to pop out, I'll probably put on this. But how do you feel like your style describes or explains you who you are?
I feel like, to me, I would be considered chilling. Mm. But to somebody else, I would be considered extra.
Okay.
So, it's like, I'm chilling, but I'm doing the most.
So it's not on you, it's in you type vibe.
Kinda, okay. But yeah. Okay. So like, I feel like chilling is like, you know, it's real simmered down. But my chilling is like,
it's outside, you pop out. Okay, yeah. I feel that. So now we're just gonna get back to your shoot, pop out some more looks, and yeah, get a vibe.
That's all right with me.